So as I'm going, I'm just slowly shaping the hole. What I like to normally do with the bridges is to create like a little bit of a cone-shaped hole. Now that becomes deeper, a cone-shaped hole when I'm double staking them. But when I'm just doing it for my drags, I can pretty much have it so I've got room for that bottom swivel just to sit in underneath my trap, and then it can bed down on top. If the trap's, when I'm bedding it, if it, the trap's a bit unstable or whatever, potential is that it's just gonna go off on me and scare everything. Now, it's never a race to set a trap. A lot of people just say, yep, whack it in, job's done, bang, dogs will come and stand on that. What's the problem? What's the issue? If it takes me 20 minutes to set it, so be it. If it takes me an hour to set it, I'll take an hour to set it, because I don't want to miss the dog and I don't want to scare him off. So different times, different soil types. It's pretty good here at the moment because we've had some rain around, some moisture, but other times I've had, and it's really hard to get that in. But spend your time being nice and neat and tidy about what you're doing, instead of just having a rush, finishing it off, have a look at it and go, oh, you know, maybe I should catch a dog. So we've got it to the stage where I've sort of got the hole where I think it should be. Just having a quick look. I might need to make a few final adjustments as I'm going. With the bridges, I just cut a little bit of room out on the side for the springs to help bed them down and go from there. What I always do before I put the trap in the ground is I'll check that my night latch or second stage is nice and clean, so there's nothing in it, so it's firing properly. It's not going to just slip past and grab me or whatever, or just go off as a misfire. Have a quick look at my chain, make sure that my D-shackle and my chain for my drag are hooked on properly, and then I'll actually set the trap on the mat and see how it goes. So I'm actually having a look at it. The feed jaw, everything seems to be fine with it. What I'm looking for is things like how the pan sits. When it's, is it nice and flat? Is it sitting up a bit too far? If so, I've got to make some fine-tune adjustments before I put that in the ground. If I just say, well, oh, it'll be all right, chances are it's not going to be all right. So I'll show you what I mean by that. So if I'm worried about anything, then I can often go and fix what I'm doing, or go and get a different trap out of my ute and put this one aside and do some work on it when I get home. What I found with the bridges and the Jakes and the Victors, some of the smaller traps that have their setups here, I don't carry them there. As a safety reasons, if that trap goes off, the first thing it'll do is smash both of my thumbs. So as a safety thing, I pick it up from underneath. If the trap goes off now, it's not going to grab me, it's not going to hurt me. So as I can see, that's my free jaw and that pan sitting up like that, which is fine for while I'm bedding the trap. When my night latch goes in, that'll come down, click into place. I've got a nice flat surface finished off there, and that's how the trap will finish off. So I just like to check that before I put it in the ground and know that it's firing properly. So now that I've quickly done that, I'll set it back up with the pan back up, and we'll see how it's looking when we're bedding it. So as I said, I'm picking it up from underneath and see how it sits into the hole. So what I'm looking for when I'm doing that is to make sure that it's just in underneath the level of the finished off dirt where I want to be. And I also want to check that when I bump the trap on either side, that the trap's not wobbling around. If it does that, a dog can actually come and walk there. If he does so, he can set the trap off. But I've had plenty of dogs come in because I've bedded them down properly, come in, stood on the springs, not on the pan, The trap hasn't gone off, the dog hasn't been scared. He's actually come back to that same spot and I've caught him later on without a problem. Same trap, everything was right. He just happened to put his foot a little bit more over to the left. So I'm making sure that that's down nice and firm so he can walk in other places on that. Once I've done that, I'm happy with that. Sometimes you might have to cut little bits and pieces out to make that a bit better. I can decide where I'm going to go with my drag, whether I want to dig my drag in that side. To me, I'm going to dig it in around the back of the tree and put my drag log there. So, as I said, I've bedded that down. I'm happy with that. So when I'm going to run my drag out, it'll go around to there where I can actually camouflage where I hook it on. I will actually dig, then I will dig all that chain in and make all that chain disappear because I don't want the dog to see any of it. So once again, I will just take my time, slowly working around. Feeding that chain in to that area, and I will go right around to where I want to set my drag up. So once I've done that, I just put that bit of dirt back over it. Have a look at that area. Now that chain's dug in.